In the previous segment, I introduced the concept of a wave function. Let us now see how the wave function looks like when we talk about a particle that has a fixed energy and momentum according to the rules of Planck and de Broglie. We are going to specify this in just one spatial dimension and therefore consider a wave that depends on a coordinate x and time t. And assume that this is a plane wave with a wave number k now for the motion in the x direction and an angular frequency omega. Now I want to introduce the idea to use mathematical operations to extract the energy and momentum of the particle out of this expression. The mathematical operation that we are going to use is taking derivatives. Let us have a look what happens when we take a derivative with respect to time of this wave function that I've specified here. So let's calculate the derivative with respect to time of this wave function. As this is an exponential function, we are going to use the chain rule. In the argument, we see that the time appears with a factor minus I omega, and according to the chain rule, this factor will now appear in front of our expression and is then multiplied by the derivative of the exponential function with respect to its generic argument. But the exponential function, as you know, is special because it does not change when you take this derivative. And so we just recover the function that we started out with, and therefore can write this simply as minus I omega times the wave function that we had at the beginning. Now I want to make a little aside and remind you of a mathematical feature that you have encountered before, which is related to vectors and matrices. And in case that you have not seen it before, we will definitely see it again later in this course, and what I show you now is just a nice and little preview of what you then will encounter. This is the fact that for any given matrix A, there are very special vectors V, so that if you multiply such a vector by the matrix, the vector does not change its direction and is only scaled in length by a scale factor lambda, which is just a number. This is not the wavelength, it's just a number that appears in these mathematical expressions. Now, these special vectors, which depend on the matrix that we are talking about, are called eigenvectors. And the scale factors here, they are called the associated eigenvalues. Right now, let's have a look what we have obtained here. Instead of multiplying a vector by a matrix, we took a function and then took its derivative, which is a mathematical operation. Indeed, we will phrase it like this. We applied an operator to a function. And what we obtained is that we recovered the same function with which we started, and it was just multiplied by a constant. In this case, we are going to call the function an eigenfunction for this mathematical operation, or this operator, and the constant in front of this function we are still going to call the eigenvalue, just as before. Now note that this eigenvalue here already contains the angular frequency, but not in the form as it is involved in the Planck rule for the energy. But this can be easily fixed by just extending this mathematical operation by the multiplication by IH bar. So let's consider the situation that instead of only taking the derivative, we also multiply the result by IH bar, which we can just do by using the expressions from above and multiplying by this constant. Now the I will cancel with the minus I in front of the omega, and so we just obtain h bar omega times psi, and so we have really extracted the expression for the energy according to the Planck rule. This suggests that we take this composed set of mathematical operations and interpret it as an operator that is associated with energy. In order to alert us to the fact that this is, however, not just a number, but a mathematical operator, we adorn it with a little hat or caret on top of it, and we call this the energy operator. Now we can do something very similar to extract the momentum of the particle. Let us have a look at the derivative of this wave function with respect to position. And applying the chain rule again, we will now extract the factor ik in front of the wave function. which does not again change when we then take the derivative of the exponential function with respect to its generic argument. And when we now multiply this expression by minus I h bar, then the factors I and minus I again cancel, and therefore we obtain the expression h bar k times psi, hence have extracted the momentum according to the de Broglie rule. So this now suggests to interpret this combination of mathematical operations as the momentum operator, which is indeed a very important operator for the rest of this course. Before we move on, let me briefly summarize what we have done here, because a lot has happened in these few lines of calculations. We started out with a wave function of a plane wave, and we introduced the concept of operators to extract some expressions that we are actually going to interpret physically as information about the properties of a given particle described by this wave. In particular, this plane wave we interpret as the wave function of a particle with a fixed energy and momentum. And in order to see which energy and momentum this is, we apply the energy operator and read off the energy as a constant that we then find in front of this function. And we similarly apply the momentum operator to this wave function and extract the momentum as a factor in front of it. Now, a key feature of waves is that they can be superimposed, which not only results in wave interference, but here would lead to a situation where a particle does not have a fixed energy and momentum. The particle is then simply described by a wave function that is not a plane wave. But this wave function should still obey a certain suitable wave equation. Indeed, what we are going to do next is to identify the operators E and P introduced here in a familiar wave equation that also applies to waves that are not monochromatic plane waves, and use this insight to write down the Schrödinger equation.